Pressure is growing on Prime Minister Scott Morrison to declare if he will attend the World Climate Summit in Glasgow at the end of the month. Before then, he'll have to deliver a new plan for cutting greenhouse gases without tearing his own government apart.
On climate change, Scott Morrison is caught between the hammer of the regional nationals.
We shouldn't be sacrificing the resources sector for the net zero heroes.
And the anvil of city-based Liberals.
Reducing our emissions and getting to net zero is vital to the leadership role that we play in the world.
And soon the Prime Minister will have to cut an emissions deal that both parties in his coalition government can live with.
Until we see how we get there and who pays for it, we cannot support something blindly.
Australia has agreed to cut greenhouse gas emissions by 26 to 28% below 2005 levels by 2030, and the Prime Minister aims to get to net zero as soon as possible and preferably by 2050. And before the World Climate Conference in November, Scott Morrison must deliver a plan for deeper emissions cuts.
I think we've got the opportunity to exceed those targets for 2030.
And why should we put ourselves at a competitive disadvantage compared with China and India and others?
One part of the government is talking up the benefits.
And I think those plans will provide new opportunities for every part of the country.
The other is focused on the costs.
And we're just over 1% of world emissions. No matter what we do here, it won't change the temperature of the globe.
With an election due by May, the Prime Minister faces another tough choice. Does he go to Glasgow and risk more time in quarantine when he needs to be campaigning?
Scott Morrison is missing in action and is refusing to go to Glasgow because he is a coward.
The climate summit begins on the 1st of November, and Scott Morrison will need to find some answers soon. Chris Yuleman, Nine News.